Do you have time series data, data with timestamps and important critical business information with that? Well, you're not going to want to miss this next episode of the AI Show where we talk about Anomaly Detector. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show where we're going to talk about the Anomaly Detector. I've got a special guest. How are you doing, my friend?
Great. How are you, Seth?
Good. Tell us who you are and what you do.
I'm Chun from China. I'm working in a Microsoft AI platform team. I'm actually the PM of Anomaly Detector, So the great service on Azure Cognitive Service.
So, and this is a brand new thing, so why don't you give us like a 10-second overview of what it is, 10,000 foot level.
Sure, 10-second, right? Yeah. Okay, so Anomaly Detector is basically an AI service, AI-powered service, an API service that's going to detect anomalies from time series.
I see.
Yeah, so time series is basically, you know, measures of any metrics and with timestamp.
I see.
Yeah, so that's what the service is.
So that's awesome. Can you give me a sense for what use cases are? Because I think I understand what you're saying, but can you tell me what use cases there are so I can get a little bit more concrete in my head?
Yeah, makes sense. Actually, I got a few cool sites
Let's
here.
Let's do it.
Yeah. So we started with, you know, business metrics because that's where we started from, actually. Business metrics is basically something, you know, we got a website and there's visitors coming in every day and there's also revenue of the website, right? Mm-hmm. That's why this website exists. Now you got those KPIs there and it has a timestamp, maybe daily or even hourly or even weekly. And you want to check that metrics, you want to monitor that metrics, you want to know when there's something wrong with it, you want to know it in time before there's a big loss to your revenue.
I see.
So with the business metrics, Anomaly Detector is trying to address, you know, the way that when something like hard threshold doesn't work, and that's why the AI is coming to work.
I see. So it's basically like if there's something happening in your business that's not expected, we want to flag that right as it's starting, that way we don't get into a bad situation.
You don't want to know it after everything is at a catastrophic failure, right?
So fantastic. So what other scenarios are there?
So business metric is just one common kind of, I would say, data that we address. The other type of scenarios that we constantly face and our customers came to us a lot is about IoT.
I see.
In industries like cars or oil and energy, uh-huh, and even some factory floors, customers will deploy the sensors in the production line, in cars and drones, right?
I see.
And those sensors will emit data, especially time series data, and in metrics like temperature, humidity, or even vibrates, how it vibrates, right? So all vibration, so all that data is basically the metrics that you don't want to monitor by human.
So I see.
Yeah, that's where we can also help.
So if a machine is getting too hot, you want to know right away before you burn up your machine.
That's
or if
real
there's a sensor, like for example, you have a fence and all of a sudden, like there's a spike in temperature, that would be something you want to look at as well.
You want to look at or you want to trigger something to turn down it, right?
Awesome.
Stop it before it's going to explode or something.
So as I'm understanding, any data that has a timestamp would be a good candidate for this.
Yeah.
But I imagine that this is a hard problem and there's some issues with it. And this is why we've got a solution. What makes this particular problem hard?
Okay, that's a great question. And that's why we shipped this product to help everyone. So because all those scenarios that I've mentioned is basically dealing with the challenge of how to detect anomalies from time series data. Because time series data by itself just has two fields. One is the timestamp and the other one is a measure.
Right.
There's nothing more about it. So if you want to detect anomalies from that, traditionally, people will set something like a threshold. Hard threshold is proven not working because with a high bar, you will likely miss a lot of anomalies.
I see. And so you're saying setting a flat number as a threshold is what's been done before, but as we go forward, that could be a problem because you might set the threshold too high, too low, and yes. then you could still cause damage.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. And the one challenge with threshold is business will change.
Yeah.
So one day this will work, the other day no, it grows or it declines. You need to reset everything.
I see.
So that's a big challenge.
Okay.
Another thing that, well, we are the AI guys, mm-hmm. and there in AI world, there are actually already some existing approaches. Maybe I would say algorithms mm-hmm. trying to address this. So as you can see in this screen, we have listed enumerated some really fancy charts, but these are really the challenges. These are the variability of real world data. You can
see.
Yeah, there are trend change. There are seasonality like this. And there are normal anomalies like spikes and dips. Uh-huh. And there are also a linear pattern here. So with all the different patterns of data, the existing solutions who are most of those are trying to find out an algorithm that one algorithm fits all.
I see.
Actually doesn't work.
And I'm looking at as I'm looking at this chart, what I'm looking at is the blue is the actual timestamp data, and the red dots are where we know there are anomalies. And
exactly.
each of these six scenarios are indications of like your data might look like this, and then it has to do this. Your data might look like this. And so it's a huge problem in that you really can't tell initially where your anomalies would be without an in-depth study of your data.
Yes, that's true. So yeah.
And it's pretty cool to see that, but. How do we go about solving it? So what is it that we've done to make this a little bit easier for customers?
Yeah, so that's the exciting part. We've got, Anomaly Detector was announced actually earlier this year in March.
Mm-hmm.
But this is not a new service. We have already been hosting or running an AI-powered anomaly detection service within Microsoft for several years.
Right.
Yeah, so this means the anomaly detection and the algorithms under the hood is actually running with Microsoft product data for hundreds of product teams. And that production data is helping us to improve those algorithms and improve the engineering efforts in the system. And now we are bringing that capability, that knowledge to you, to customers, to our customers, and as the anomaly detector. Yeah.
And this is pretty cool because even though it's a new product as of March, this isn't a new thing to Microsoft. We have all of this stored up knowledge and data of what anomalies look like in all of our various business processes, and we're using that data to actually help customers predict on anomalies in their data. Is that correct?
Yes. Yes. So today we are, there are a lot of customers coming to us with various scenarios and various challenges in their business problems. So as you can see, all those variability of data, like the challenges in the existing solutions mm-hmm. and that cannot be addressed, we are able to address. So I got a few points here.
Cool.
So, first is about the variability, right? All those
right.
fancy charts.
Those points, yeah.
One algorithm fits all is not working, so we are coming with a pool of algorithms. We got a lot of algorithms. The innovation here is first we will detect your data pattern. We found the algorithm that best fit your data, and to apply the algorithm to your data in order to have the best accuracy. Also, we have, I like to mention this because this is my favorite part.
Right.
We have this SRCNN, which stands for Spectral Residue and Convolutional Neural Network.
That's really cool.
Well, that sounds really cool, and that is cool. That's a kind of a novel algorithm and model that's recently developed by my team, Anomaly Detector team.
Oh, fantastic.
And there's a paper which is already accepted by KDD 2019.
That's so cool.
So, yeah.
So I'm looking at this, and it's just dawned on me that the problem of anomaly detection is kind of the same problem with all of AI, in that you have to first pick an algorithm that might work for your data, and then you have to shuffle through this. But you're saying that the anomaly detection service will go through and figure out which algorithm would be the best one to use.
Yeah, And the best part of it, you don't even have to know that, because we hide everything under the hood. So the beauty of the service is we try to address the requirements not only for data scientists, but also for developers. Developers who can write code with C#, mm-hmm. Java. So which means we actually ship this as AI service, mm-hmm. and every algorithm, every the complexity about the parameters mm-hmm. that you need to tune each algorithm are all hidden under the hood.
Fantastic.
And what's left there is this API and this one parameter, which we call sensitivity. Leave you a bit flexibility there, mm-hmm. but still, if you are just a developer, not a data scientist. Yeah, you are able to empower, building this into your application, no problem.
So can you show us a little demo, maybe to get us started?
Of course.
Okay, let's do that.
Yeah. So we actually, this is Azure Portal.
Okay.
We actually started with something called the resource on Azure Portal, because it's API service. But what you need is a anomaly detector resource on Azure that's going to host the APIs. Mm-hmm. So let me show. So this is a way that you create an anomaly detector resource. If you see this, that's where you are.
Nice.
And then put input name. And let me do this quick. So far, we have two regions, West US and West Europe. Mm-hmm. As we go into GA, there will be more, a lot of more actually.
Got it.
So pricing tier. So if you are the first time user, you will still have this option for the free tier. But I'm not, so I got.
You are not a first time user.
No, I'm not. Otherwise, I will not be talking about this.
Right.
Okay. Let me create group.
So this is just as easy as creating any other service.
Okay. Yes, exactly. This is the typical Azure portal, Azure resource creation. Mm-hmm. And once you got this resource, that's a fun part. Let me switch to this notebook first. So what we hosted on the Azure notebook platform is basically a few Jupyter notebooks that data scientists and developers both like. I'm going to show you how interesting and easy it is. So yeah, you go to the Azure notebooks. First, you need to sign in.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it will be read-only to you. If you want to play with your own notebook, go to this project and clone your own instance.
And we'll get these links in the bottom of the show notes, so if you want to do this, you can.
Yeah. Let me make another clone here. Oh. You don't want to check this, otherwise the project will be public to anyone on the internet. So while it's being created, while it's being cloned, let's go to the resource. Let me see, where is it? Yeah. Sure. That's it.
Looks like it was made.
Yeah, it is. So as you can see, there's the overview and everything. What you need to take note down is include two things. One is this endpoint. It's West US 2. I already got this, so I'm not going to copy and paste, but this is one thing. And the other thing is the keys. You can click here, got this API key, because you are going to call the API with that. And once you got your notebook project here, and this is clone of yours, you can actually run on free compute. It's free. So with that, I'm just going to run it really quick.
Very good.
Yeah, this is the notebook, and all you have to do is paste your key here. So we can do this, actually. And the endpoint, this is correct. But if you create in West EU, remember to change this. And this is the previous result. I can actually run, clean everything, and run again. run all.
Fantastic. And so basically, if you want to get started quickly, and this, all you do is create the service, clone these notebooks, and then just run it, and then you have something to look at to work on later on.
Yes, yes. There are all those requirement about the, you know, the keys, the endpoint. It's all from the resource that you created on Azure, and within this notebook, you can, you know, play with the parameter that I've mentioned, the sensitivity, also mm-hmm. the data. And that's saved side by side with the notebook. You can change that, and you can run on anomaly detection. Well, it's working now. So as you can see, these are anomalies detected from the data that's sitting here. These are JSONs.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
And the other thing is, like, you didn't just, you literally created the services, cloned the notebook, and so everything that you saw happen literally happened right here, which is pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
So where can people go to find out more? How can they get started?
Yeah, I got this slide here that can help you, really a few highlighted links that help you start with. So first, yeah, go to aka.ms anomaly detector or search on Bing for anomaly detector, Azure Anomaly Detector. Mm-hmm. You'll get to the overview. And then we also have this community. Mm-hmm. That's a Teams group, Microsoft Teams group, that we host for both external customers and internal Microsoft guys and ourselves, the engineering team. Yeah, there's a form here. You can go there and join, apply to join. And finally, the containers. Well, I'm going to talk about this in our next episode.
Fantastic. So thank you so much for spending some time with us. Thank you so much for watching. We've been learning all about Anomaly Detector, an amazing new service that you should check out today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.